हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, इन आवर प्रीवियस लेक्चर वी आर सॉल्व ए प्रॉब्लम नंबर 7 ऑन कंप्यूटेशन ऑफ बुक प्रॉफिट एंड टोटल टैक्सेबल इनकम ऑफ द फर्म। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू सॉल्व ए प्रैक्टिकल प्रॉब्लम नंबर 8 ऑन कंप्यूटेशन ऑफ बुक प्रॉफिट एंड टोटल इनकम ऑफ द फर्म। यर प्रॉब्लम नंबर 8, आनंद एंड भूषण आर द वर्किंग पार्टनर्स इन ए बिजनेस फर्म। सो आनंद एंड भूषण बोथ आर पार्टनर्स एंड बोथ आर वर्किंग पार्टनर्स इन ए बिजनेस फर्म, शेयरिंग प्रॉफिट्स एंड लॉसेस इन द रेशियो ऑफ शेयरिंग प्रॉफिट एंड लॉसेस इन द रेशियो ऑफ 3:2। The capital account of each partner showed a credit balance of rupees 1 lakh. Okay, so capital balance of each partner is rupees 1 lakh as on 1st April 2020. Following is the profit and loss account of the firm for the year ending 31st March 2020. Okay. So here profit and loss account is also given of firm for the year ending 31st March 2020. Okay. So we start to read the problem from additional information. If additional information is given, then we read the additional information carefully. So here donation includes, first additional information, donation include rupees 1000 paid as subscription to trade association and the balance to the National Defense Fund. So donation includes rupees 1000 for association of the business. So donation is paid, so all the donation is disallowed. Okay. So here all donation are disallowed, so find out the donation. So donation is disallowed. So adjustment is given, but all donation is given to charity, donation is given to National Defense Fund, donation is institution, all are disallowed. Okay, so donation all are disallowed. Make a star in front of donation. Donation rupees 4000, all are disallowed. Then municipal taxes paid and repairs pertains to house property. So municipal tax and repairs, so here both these are related to municipal tax and repairs are related to house property, related to house property. So house property expenses, it means a expenses related to personal or the expenses related to house property. So house property is a wealth of the proprietor and it is a personal expenditure of that proprietor. So it is not a business expenditure. Okay, it is a expenditure related to house property of the owner. So these are disallowed expenditure. Then depreciation allowable as per IT rule, it means income tax rule, rupees 5000. So here depreciation is given here. So depreciation is charged on the profit and loss account of the firm is rupees 6000 and allowable depreciation is rupees 5000. It means 1000 depreciation is excess charged on the debit side of profit and loss account and that excess depreciation is disallowed. Okay, got it? So excess depreciation is disallowed. So we read all the adjustment related to respective items and we make a star in front of those item which is adjustment is given. Okay, so here we read all adjustment. Now we read profit and loss account debit side. So salary to staff is allowable expenditure. To salary to partner, so partner salary is add in net profit, then working partner salary is allowable for a deduction. So first of all we add salary, then we get a deduction of salary for working partners. Then interest on capital, so interest on capital is ₹18,000. So we have to compute a percentage of interest and then we decide how much interest is taxable or not. Okay, so interest on capital, so working note, we make a working note to compute a percentage of interest on capital. Here percentage of interest on capital is not given, so we find out a percentage of interest on capital easily. That is each partner's capital account show a ₹1 lakh. It means Anand contributed a capital of ₹1 lakh and Bhushan contributed capital for a firm ₹1 lakh. Okay, so we easily compute a percentage of interest. Okay, in last lecture we find out a percentage of interest on capital. Same method is apply here, and then we find out the interest is taxable or not. Then office expenses. Office expenses is allowable expenditure of the firm. Okay, office expenses is allowable expenditure. Then bad debts. So bad debts, in bad debts adjustment is not given. Okay, or in bad debts or in front of bad debts, they did not say the bad debts is disallowed. If in problem it is said that bad debts is disallowed, then we add this bad debts in net profit. But if no adjustment is given on bad debt, so bad debt is considered as a loss of the business. Okay, so it is allowable expenditure. To provision for bad debts, it means all provisions and reserves are disallowed. Okay, all provisions and reserves are disallowed, ₹2,500. Got it? So we read a debit side here, then we get a net profit, and net profit is ₹4,000. Okay, so net profit is very important while computing the total income of the firm. So net profit is equal to 4000. Then we read a credit side of profit and loss account. Here by gross profit 1,47,000, then by rent from house property ₹12,000, and by interest on post office ₹1,000. So both of these two income are from other sources, so it is deducted from the net profit. Okay, because it is increases the net profit, so that we deduct this income from the net profit. Okay, so income from house property is the income from other source. It is not related to the business or firm, so that this income is disallowed income. Got it? Yes sir, we got it. Then we read all the problem carefully. Now we go to solve the problem. So here net profit as per profit and loss account, net profit as per profit and loss account, so net profit is 4000, which is given in the profit and loss account debit side, amounted to ₹4,000. Okay, then we add inadmissible expenses debited to P&L account. Okay, inadmissible expenses debited to profit and loss account. Got it? Yes, sir. Then we start from adjustment. So first adjustment is donation. So all donation are disallowed. So here add donation amounted to rupees here donation amounted to rupees 4000. Okay, donation amounted to rupees 4000. Is disallowed. Donation amounted to rupees 4000. In inner column 4000. Then next second adjustment or second additional information, municipal tax paid and repairs pertains to house property. It means municipal tax and repairs are related to house property of the owner, so it is not a expenditure of the business. So here both of these expenditure is related to house property, so it is not related to the business. Okay, rupees 2000 and repairs rupees 500, so both are disallowed. So add municipal tax amounted to rupees 2000 and repairs amounted to rupees 500. 500. Then the next adjustment, the next adjustment is last depreciation. So depreciation is given here. So depreciation is charged on the debit side is rupees 6000. Okay, and allowable depreciation as per income tax rule rupees 5000. It means excess depreciation is charged on the debit side of profit and loss account, so excess depreciation is disallowed. So add the excess depreciation in net profit. So here add excess depreciation. How we calculated, that is 6000 minus allowable depreciation 5000. So taxable amount is rupees, or disallowed amount is rupees 1000. Got it? Then we solve all adjustments. Now we go to the debit side of profit and loss account and find out inadmissible expenses of the firm and add these inadmissible or disallowed expenses in net profit. So interest on capital is the first point. So find out the percentage of interest given to respective partners. So how we find out? So in last lecture we compute a percentage of interest on capital. So how we compute? So capital is rupees, so capital is given, capital of the partner is given, so capital of each partner is rupees 1 lakh. Okay, so as per this capital we compute a percentage of interest paid to the Anand and Bhushan. Okay, so here 1 lakh is 100%, then 18,000 is how much percentage? So here we make a cross multiplication. So 18,000 into 100 divided by 1 lakh. is equal to, so we get a percentage of interest on capital. So 1 lakh or 18,000 multiplied by 100 divided by 1 lakh, it means 18% rate of interest is given to both partners. Okay, so here 18% rate of interest on capital is paid to respective partners. It means 18% interest on capital is charged to Bhushan and Anand. So here exempted interest on capital is up to rupees or up to 12%. Okay, not in rupees, it is a exempted up to 12%. So it is a working note. Okay, working note to find out a percentage of interest on capital. So capital is given, capital is equal to 100%. So 18,000 is equal to how much percent? So we calculate or we make a cross multiplication. So we get a 18% rate of interest on capital is charged. Okay, so 18% is charged on capital. So exempted interest on capital is up to rupees 12%. So first of all we add interest on capital. So here x is interest on capital of Anand at the rate 18% amounted to rupees 18,000. Okay, amounted to rupees 18,000 less exempted up to 12%, that is 18,000 into 12 divided by 18, it means 12,000 is exempted and remaining balance 12,000 is exempted. It means remaining balance, that is 6,000, is disallowed. Okay, it means 6,000 is disallowed or 6,000 is taxable. Same as it is interest on capital of Bhushan at the rate 18% amounted to rupees 18,000 less exempted up to 12%, it means the amount is same. 12% of 18,000 is 12,000, that is 6,000 is taxable. 6,000. Okay, then we add a expenses which is not related to the firm, second one. So here interest on capital is add municipal tax and repair. So municipal tax and repairs we add, already add. Okay, here. Okay, so we add all the expenses which is not related to firm. So make the total provision for RDD or bad debts is not write it here. So add a provision for RDD. So provision for bad debts. All provisions are disallowed. So here we forgot to disallow the provision for bad debts. Okay, so provision for bad debts or all provisions are disallowed. Amounted to rupees 2500. Amounted to rupees 2500. 2500. So we add all disallowed or inadmissible expenses in net profit. Okay, but here we did not add, only write it on the inner column. So make the total of inner column. Okay, make the total of inner column. So total is rupees 4000 plus 2000, 6500, 7500, 8000, 10000, 10000 plus 6000, 16000, 16000 plus 6000, that is 22000. Okay, so 22000 is all disallowed expenses total. So add this 22000 in net profit of the firm, that is 4000, and the total is 26000. Okay, 26000. Okay, then we deduct less income chargeable under other heads credited to P&L account. Okay, so income credited to P&L account from other sources is given here, that is to income from other sources is credited to profit and loss account. So here rent from house property 12000 and interest on post office 1000. Okay, so deduct this income. So rent from house property amounted to rupees 12000 and second income from interest on saving bank account of post office amounted to rupees 1000. Okay, so make the total, and the total is 13000. So 13000 is deducted from 13000 is deducted from net profit we get a net profit is rupees 13000. Okay, then we add एड रेमुनरेशन ऑफ पार्टनर्स. ओके सो रेमुनरेशन ऑफ पार्टनर्स इज गिवन हियर. ओके सो रेमुनरेशन ऑफ पार्टनर्स इन प्रॉफिट एंड लॉस अकाउंट द सैलरी इज गिवन टू आनंद एंड भूषण. सो सैलरी टू पार्टनर्स इज गिवन हियर. ओके सो सैलरी इज गिवन टू आनंद. सो रेमुनरेशन इंक्लूड्स हियर इन टू ब्रैकेट रेमुनरेशन इज इक्वल टू सैलरी प्लस कमीशन प्लस बोनस. ओके यस मीन्स सैलरी, सी मीन्स कमीशन, बी मीन्स बोनस. ओके आर ई एम मीन्स रेमुनरेशन. सो रेमुनरेशन इज इक्वल टू सैलरी प्लस कमीशन प्लस बोनस. सो हियर रेमुनरेशन ऑफ आनंद. ओके सो रेमुनरेशन ऑफ आनंद इज इक्वल टू रेमुनरेशन ऑफ आनंद इज इक्वल टू सैलरी प्लस कमीशन. सो सैलरी इज रुपीज, सैलरी इज रुपीज 34,000. 34,000 सो सैलरी गिवन टू बोथ ऑफ पार्टनर इज इक्वल 34,000. कमीशन प्लस कमीशन सो कमीशन सैलरी टू आनंद. ओके कमीशन टू आनंद. सो कमीशन इज नॉट गिवन टू द पार्टनर. सो इन अमाउंटिंग कॉलम इट इज नील. ओके सो इट इज नील. देन बोनस टू आनंद. सो बोनस टू आनंद, बोनस टू आनंद. सो बोनस इज नॉट गिवन टू एनी पार्टनर. ओके सो बोनस टू आनंद इज ऑल्सो नील. बोनस इज नॉट गिवन सो अमाउंट इज नील. देन वी मेक ए टोटल ऑफ रेमुनरेशन ऑफ आनंद. सो टोटल इज 34,000. ओके टोटल इज 34,000. देन वी कंप्यूट ए रेमुनरेशन ऑफ भूषण. सो हियर सेकंड पार्टनर दैट इज रेमुनरेशन, रेमुनरेशन ऑफ भूषण, भूषण. सो सैलरी, सैलरी टू भूषण. सो सैलरी टू भूषण इज इक्वल टू 34,000. सो सैलरी इज गिवन टू भूषण अमाउंटेड रुपीज 34,000 प्लस कमीशन, कमीशन टू भूषण. सो कमीशन इज नॉट गिवन टू भूषण. सो कमीशन इज नॉट गिवन टू आनंद एज वेल एज भूषण. सो अमाउंट इज नील, नील. देन बोनस टू भूषण. सो बोनस इज नॉट गिवन टू आनंद एज वेल एज भूषण. सो अमाउंटिंग कॉलम इज नील, अमाउंटिंग कॉलम नील. ओके देन वी एड दिस 34,000 एज द रेमुनरेशन. 34,000. ओके 34,000 इज द रेमुनरेशन ऑफ ए. सो टोटल रेमुनरेशन इज एड इन, टोटल रेमुनरेशन इज एड इन. सो टोटल रेमुनरेशन ऑफ बोथ पार्टनर इज 68,000. ओके 68,000. एड दिस 68,000 इन 13,000. सो 13,000 plus 68,000, that is we get a book profit, and the amount is called, we get the figure, that is 81,000, and that 81,000 is called, that 81,000 is called that 81,000 is called book profit. Okay, amounted to rupees 81,000. Okay, 81,000. Then we deduct. Then we deduct less. Then we deduct less allowable remuneration. Allowable remuneration for deduction under section 40B for working partners only. Okay, so here salary a salary to Anand, so here remuneration to Anand and Bhushan. Okay, so remuneration to Anand and Bhushan here 68,000. Okay, we already compute a remuneration of both the partners, that is 68,000. So 68,000, write it in inner column, 68,000. Okay, 68,000 into bracket here, that is salary to Anand plus Bhushan, okay, is equal to 34,000 plus 34,000, okay, is equal to 68,000. Okay, got it? Yes, sir. Then B part B, that is 90% of book profit. So book profit is 81,000. 81,000 into 90%, that is so here 90 divided by 100 into 81,000. Okay, we get a 90% of book profit, that is 72,900, and then we get a deduction, that is whichever is lower from A and B. Okay, so here into bracket, whichever is less from A and B, okay, from A and B. Okay, got it? Okay, A and B, whichever is lower is allowed for a deduction. Then we make A total. So total is equal to, so the total is 68,081,000. Here 81,000 is the book profit. Okay. So here allowable deduction is rupees 68,000. Okay. 68,000. So deduct the 68,000 from 81,000. We get a income from firm. So 81,000 minus 68,000, that is 13,000. 13,000 is the total taxable income of the firm. Okay. So 13,000 is total income from firm. Got it? Yes, sir. So here we solve a problem number 8 on computation of book profit and total income from firm. Okay. So very easy problem we solve here. Now in our next lecture, we are solve a practical problem number 9. Okay, practical problem 9. Okay, so problem number 9 is same as per we solve the problem number 8. Okay, slight difference is given in problem number 9 and problem number 8. Okay, we will solve this problem number 9 in our next video. Okay, thank you. Thank you very much.